yeah, if I do that, you know, people remember how they feel, not like what you say, you know. So I try to be feeling so that everyone else can be feeling as well.
When did you know that you wanted to pursue music on your own? I know growing up with that influence was powerful.
Maybe like a couple years ago, I really wanted to do it. I just like was shy. Everyone's like, what? And I'm like, I know, but I was shy. And then I kind of was trying to do anything else but music, but it just wasn't really clicking. So one day I was just like, maybe I'm resisting something that I need to be doing. I don't like to resist things, I like to like allow things to happen. So once I stopped resisting it, I just went for it. And here I am.
What connections have you made on your journey?
Lots of connections. Connections like this, connections like this. The music industry, the creative industry, I mean, just being creative is a bit cool. Everyone's cool, but they're also crazy, but they're also cool. Gives me more things to write about. No, go ahead.
Are you feeling like overwhelmed with like your new journey as a musician, considering who your father is? Like, are you afraid about those filling those shoes or?
No, I'm not really trying to fill any shoes. Just kind of different what I'm doing. I mean, I sing, obviously, I'm not playing an instrument. So I guess that's my instrument. And, you know, it's just, it comes out of me, music comes out of me in a different way than it comes out of, I mean, everyone, my parents, my friends, like my peers, you know. I just think that if you honor how it comes out of you the best, like, it's not really about comparing, it's just about making sure that you're doing, you're staying true to yourself.
The DJ Complex, how did you like opening for Kanye, Tribe, and Gangstar?
Oh, man, that was, you got the word, right, Complex?
According to your bio.
Oh, man, I don't know who that was. But nah, man, I would love to open up for something, man, but actually tonight, like just being on this festival, it was, I'm not even gonna hold you, man, I was nervous. Like just seeing my name up there with like people that I like respected, people that I grew up listening to. So, I mean, I got nervous, man, but it's, I mean, it's what I like to do, what I'm destined to do, man. So I'm excited now. Got over that nervous part, man. I'm ready to rock out.
I mean, Lauryn Hill was a really big, I was like obsessed with her when her album came out when I was like 15 or 14, I think. And she also was on my dad's album at that time that came out. So I like went to all like four of her shows for the Miss Education. I was like obsessed. You know, I get a lot of comparisons just vocally, not like musically, but just vocally to like Amy Winehouse, who I love, Nelly Furtado, who I love, Licky Lee, who's also interesting and different. So, you know, I like the, I don't know, like the unique sound. I'm drawn to that. But I mean, everyone kind of, I'm inspired by anyone who's like really going for it and like really themselves.
Can you talk about your latest project?
projects. Well, I'm not signed, so I'm kind of making the rules myself. And I've been working on music, working on rolling out that music with all the other stuff that comes along with it. So I'm kind of, I haven't put out anything since I put out my first album last summer. Putting out a song in a couple of weeks, which would be the first thing since last summer, but I wrote it a while ago. And I'm just kind of wanting to drop stuff and like see what happens and then keep doing it. And then, you know, it makes sense to have make a project and it just feels cohesive and it doesn't make sense separately, then I'll do that. But I'm not really forcing anything at the moment. I have a bunch of music that I've made though lined up. It's just not necessarily like one thing, because it doesn't make sense at the moment, but maybe later it will make sense to put it together. Imagine like old music theaters where it's like people are like running and it's like someone just like standing there. It really feels like that. And so I guess I just have trained myself to be able to bring that focus despite what's happening around me.
DJ Complex, who are some of your DJing idols?
Kid Capri made me want to start. DJ Premier. There were local radio personalities like DJ Mike Tech, like Uzi D, Tommy G from around the area, and DJ Scratch. So many, but honestly, Kid Capri made me want to start. It was an episode of MTV Raps. And he did this blend of like Mary J. Blige, and he took a break beat from that point on. Like, I think I may have been like maybe 12 years old from that point on. And I was like, that's what made me want to do it, still to this day.
Well, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.